Cord care. So it's important to know that the umbilical cord should be looked after properly. There is no need to routinely use alcohol wipes, antibiotic powders, or creams. And if you use any of these, it may actually delay the separation of the cord. You should avoid covering the cord with a nappy. So the nappy should be folded below. This means it doesn't accrue moisture because if you are closing it, it becomes anaerobic. Anaerobes multiply and it may be smelly. It becomes soggy and it breaks off unevenly. So it's important to leave it to dry. The colonization with the aerobes is important and it causes the separation at the base. So keeping it dry is important. If the cord is starting to separate at the base, it will be a bit sticky around the edges. So cleaning those sticky areas with wet cotton or alcohol swab at that stage when it is separating is fine. The advice for cord care can be different in developing countries, especially in rural areas where hygiene may be an issue. But in developed countries where infection is not a big concern, it's important to follow the advice as above. Some studies in developing countries support the use of antibiotic application, but in the past 8 years in UAE, I have not seen a single significant umbilical sepsis, possibly one baby where it wasn't clear why the infection happened. Redness around the cord site or purulent discharge, we should consider umbilical sepsis. This is potentially serious because the umbilical cord, the umbilical vein runs through the liver. And if the infection in the umbilicus reaches the liver, it can be dangerous. And there is a condition called portal hypertension, which can present later. That's also important. So this is a typically infected umbilicus. You have significant redness all around, and sometimes pus discharge comes from here. That is an indication for IV antibiotic treatment, intravenous antibiotics. Umbilical granuloma is a far commoner problem where you get a little bit of the granulation tissue remaining at the base. Majority of the time, if you keep it clean and dry, it shrinks with time. So normally, if it is not oozing, we don't need to do anything. If there is a definite ooze, we can apply some fusidin or antibiotic creams. And if it persists even after 2-3 weeks of age, we can consider treatment. One of the traditional ways of treating it is applying a little bit of salt, but remember that salt is granular and crystalline. It can abrade if you rub. So if you are applying salt, leave it for a few minutes, 2 to 3 hours, and then you have to wash it off. You can apply it 2-3 times a day and review after a few days. If it persists, you may need silver nitrate cauterization. If it is significant sized, if it is small, you can just observe it. So you should also differentiate it from umbilical polyp and persistent vitellointestinal duct. So if it is looking red and bulging, we may need to refer to the surgeon to think of a polyp or an adenoma in umbilicus. This will need resection.